So, double dwarves. Oh no, sorry, dwarves and Imlargis versus double Lorien. And of course, Samsara's made an elven lord hero. I'm shocked.
All right, we're all loading. Everything's good. Everything is bright and beautiful.
Sorry. Oh god, the Samsara connection. I'm faster than him.
Well, it's actually kind of funny because...
Although Snoosum's pretty slow as well.
It's kind of funny because Samsara and Devils are both, like, very obviously British. You know, like, they got the really super heavy British accent.
Well, Samsara's got a Welsh accent, but okay. Alright, so...
Is he Welsh? He sounds yes. British to me.
Well, Wales is part of Britain, so yeah.
Well, yeah, but they've always had their own sort of thing going on, you know. What with the crazy names and the shenanigans.
Alright, I shall watch the uber-competitive play of Samsara.
20 minutes later, he still hasn't built anything.
Devils is putting his faith in Ered Lorien. Let's see how that goes. He's not making... Oh, he's going with a heroic statue charge. Or a rush. Hero rush.
Yep.
Good luck, have fun. May the best team win. Damn it, none of that. This is competitive, yo.
I have gotten so many followers this stream. It's ridiculous.
I mean, it's almost like I made a... Oh my god, look at that custom hero in the bottom right.
Holy shit.
Yes.
And his name is Haldir's Hairy Armpit.
Haldir's Hairy Armpit is a dwarf with
He might have just won right there. Like, that's
look at
it.
The side.
It's over.
Well done, Snoosome. You legend. He's made Haldir, he's made the brothers Haldir,
holy
and the dwarf
hero. Look at the hero on the left.
Hold on.
Oh my god, read the hero on
I
the left
I thought I was
name.
The weird one going with purple. Everyone else is too,
read,
what the
read his name. Read his name.
Wait, I need him to stop. No, Haldir's second okay, no. The bottom team are winning this. I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck anymore. They are winning. No, cryptic. Can you imagine how funny it would be if Haldir's second chin kills Thorin Oakenshield? Like, come on. That'll be so good.
That is incredible. By the way, just so you know for future, if you click on a custom hero and hover over their palantir to show their name, so you don't have to have them stand still.
Oh, right, yeah.
But, oh my god, that is genius. And they're both bright pink.
And Samsara's here is Gear Garad. So Japanese Gilgalad. Gear Garad.
Yeah,
so
already
well done on that.
And then Devil's...
Right, so the rush in the middle.
Oh yeah, Devil's hero is a little presumptive. His name is You Will Die.
That's a great name for a dwarf, dude.
That is, I mean, it's not as good as Haldir's Hairy Armpit, but it's pretty good.
It's a close... Dude, I'm liking this game. We've got a nice little rush going on.
Die.
They're taking the middle.
Oh my god. It's just so good.
So they're
good.
Really sacrificing the early game eco because they've built nothing in their bases.
Yeah.
Nothing in either of their bases.
I wonder if their strategy is to try and win without building anything in their base. They did say they had really scrubby tactics that they were going to employ.
Well, Heisenberg's already got the Caetrol gold, so
I love that
fucking dwarf though. He's so, like, you can spot him on the battlefield anywhere. I mean, just look at him.
Snoozum has a Mirkwood building. Holy crap, Haldir's Hairy Armpit has 7,000 health on level 1.
That's what happens when you max out the health on a dwarven custom hero.
And give him stubbornness, or toughness.
Jeez, Mirkwood is coming out. How the fuck do they have that much money from Mirkwood after all those heroes?
4k.
That makes no sense. Alright.
He literally just built one custom hero and then built a Mirkwood. That's all he's built.
And Devils is discovering he was second to the Cave Shoulder. Sad face.
It's like he's second in life. Oh! Anyways.
Oh, sorry. This is where the MLG horn plays? Right. I'll get on that post-edit. Alright, so...
I cannot wait to see your editing on that. That's gonna be... Oh,
alright. But, so yeah, they... You said scrubby tactics, but you seem to be doing everything right so far.
I don't even care, man. At this point, after those custom heroes...
Can I say just well done on the custom heroes? Like, if you're watching... If you're in this game and you're watching, just well done. Like, give yourself a pat on the back. That's great.
Yeah. Like, you have just...
I'm so impressed.
You won the internet with those custom heroes right there. Oh, and look at that. Samsara's got Haldir out. Or no, that's Heisenberg.
No, they both went for the Haldir.
Haldir and a custom hero right off the bat. That is incredible.
Gil Garrett is fighting Haldir's second chin.
And losing badly.
Jeez. He's gone for these. You
just don't mess with Haldir's second chin. It will fuck you up.
Haldir and his second chin are fighting side by side. It's literally a manifestation of his chin.
And then Haldir and his hairy
This tournament is the best yet worst idea. This is... What have we unleashed upon the world?
Haldir and his hairy armpit. No, his hairy armpit is almost dead.
Shit.
How is a dwarf almost dead when he has 7,000 health? He must have, like, no armor.
Yep.
Oh my god. He's got no health.
Dude, well done, devils. But yeah, that's a big blow for Samsara, who lost his custom hero. And Second Shin has a heal, which he's already used, and Blade Master. That's actually a pretty good... It's a very offensive talent set he's gone with. He's got Spear Throw and Blade Master.
I want the Southern players to win so badly now because of those custom heroes. Like, I want them to continue with those custom heroes. God damn it. They're probably not going to because Devils is, of the players here, Devils is the best, which is saying a lot, but... Oh, man.
Let's have a look at his base real quick. Has he got his...
Trevor McGregor 16 says, his damn, Cryptic is annoying. Well, Trevor, if I'm so annoying, why the fuck are you still watching?
Old.
I'm going to be straight about it. Got a big fight going on in the middle.
It looks... Yep. Yeah. You will die, just died. That's a bit ironic.
Oh, Thorin Broken Shield just killed Haldir's second chin.
No, you bastard! He just sunk into the ground. That's the first time I've seen a chin sink into the ground. Jeez.
Oh, okay. He was kidding. You didn't give me any indication you were joking there. Like, at all.
No, I think he was serious, and then he saw, like, the response and decided to back down. But also, how the fuck did he get... Is Snoozen hacking? How the hell has he got so many archers out so quickly? Like, Merkur doesn't build that quickly unless he has the mob.
He's got multiple palace or troop chambers. Oh, no, he doesn't. He only has one. Huh.
Damn, Snoozen. You scary.
He's got them strats. If he put a couple of troop chambers on there, he can get Merkwood archers for, like, 50. It's totally balanced.
Yep.
They're pretty solid.
We've seen a number of heroes die already. Dude, it's awesome.
Yeah, like, this is what I wanted when I set up this rule system. This is what I was hoping for.
So who's dead? You will die in Second Shin and Gil-Garad.
Yep.
So the only one who hasn't died is that big pink dwarf.
Haldir's hairy armpit is the last dwarf standing.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, goodness.
Rip him, Lardress. That hurts me to say it, but rip. Dude, those Lorien plays, though. Am I going to have to fight these guys? Or am I fighting someone else?
Well, I mean, to be fair, if you do, then you get to fight Haldir's second chin. Which is just a glorious privilege. Yeah, that's the big weakness of Imladris, his archers, and he's taking full advantage of that.
Yeah, it takes so long for them to get archers.
Well, it's just they're generally weak to archers because they're small battalion sizes. They get fucking destroyed by archers. So it's their biggest weakness, actually. If you want to counter Imladris, you want to go for archers. And considering Arid Lumen archers are the best of the Dwarven archers, it's a good combo. Well, I guess Axe Throwers are pretty good, too. Overall, the Arid Lumen ones are a bit better. Axe Throwers are glass cannons. Oh, Zayd is here.
Yo, Zayd, what's up?
How's it going, bro?
The guy who's actually become quite a good player today.
Yeah, I've been watching him play. I watched a couple of his videos he uploaded. Watched him get progressively better. I avoided posting novel long comments. I was like, I'll just let him learn.
Can Arid Lumen take down the Mirkwood Fortress? I don't think so.
Has the Mirkwood got
Harry Armpit's going in. Harry Armpit's going in. You will die versus Harry Armpit.
Hey, the second chin is back. They're fighting Broken Shield, I think.
You cannot kill.
Oh, the spear throw. That does so much fucking damage. It's unreal how much damage that does. Look at his health. It took him down to like half.
Yeah, the early game aggro from Lorien, like, there's not much Immortus can do, so Devil's just sort of on his own. Also, they're stunning a lot of his units. How are they? Is that with the that's with Helder's Shining Arrow, isn't it?
Oh yeah, Helder's arrow is fucking broken. So you don't know that?
No, Kendra, I did. I like forgot that forgot he had it.
It has a recharge timer of like 40 seconds or something stupid like that. It's so unfair. Yes.
Did Thorin die? Did he get him in the mine?
I don't see him in the mine.
Snoozing, pulling no punches, get fucked.
Helder OP.
Dude, this team is just one big Helder tribute. Well done.
He's got a level 5 Helder already! I just love those flamboyant pink heroes. They're so good. I can't get over it. It's perfect.
The Lore Master's coming out. I don't think it's going to make a difference. He needs an army.
Yeah, Zay, that's precisely why I avoided posting those long comments, because I saw Gotham was already doing it. Hey, he's got the summon reinforcements ready on Howder's second chin. He's only got 4,375 health, though. He's not that tanky. He probably went for a glass cannon approach, and then... Ah, so I see. So the hairy armpit is the tanky one, and the second chin is the damage dealer.
Hairy armpit is 7,500 health at level. That is absurd.
It's obscene, is what it is. Oh. But we're learning a lot about Howder's anatomy today. Turns out his
armpits are
really sturdy.
Can Snoozum just design anything I ever do ever? Because that is just the most beautiful dwarven hero I've ever seen. I'm starstruck by it. It's so good.
I'm gonna watch back your gameplay of this, and it's just gonna be you zoomed in on the dwarven hero the entire game.
You make the joke now. Just wait till you watch it back.
Yeah, Devils lost Broken Shield. How do you lose Broken Shield, Devils? You fucking scrub. You filthy.
That's bait, Devils.
Fuck.
That's bait. Don't fall for it.
Oh well, we got Lore Masters coming out from Samsara. And his Gyrgyrad has been revived. Gyrgyrad's got, looks like exactly the same powers that were on the previous Elven hero in the one game we had earlier. Who was that? It was Chiskun and Doza versus the other two guys.
Yeah, that wasn't really a match.
Yeah, that wasn't a
that
game.
That was an episode of How Not to Win.
Yeah. Matt Pollitt, take notes.
I think he's revived Broken Shield. I saw him a second ago. Where the fuck is he? Oh no, maybe he didn't. Maybe just Keely was alive that whole time.
This chat is very interesting.
Are they still talking about baby Balrogs?
No, it said, he said, Capetick, I want you to box Ross to the death.
Yeah, I think Trevor's got brain damage, so I just ignore him.
Yeah. Oh! See, I tell him to fuck off, you just ignore him. Both equally rude. Although,
I'm trying to host a tournament here. I ain't got time to look after brain damaged people. It's not my fault.
Trevor McGregor, brain damage confirmed. Alright, well, we got a big army of dwarves in the north with You Will Die, who only has 5,000 health, or 6,000 rather. Which is pathetic for a dwarf.
Now, letting them build up, maybe Devil should just quickly get his upgrades out. He's researching heavy armor now.
Upgrades aren't really important, as Eredluin. You want
to... You cut off. You want to what?
I said upgrades aren't really important. You want to go for heroes and Mithril as quickly as possible, because Broken Shield.
Right. Okay. Beautiful Mirkwood units.
Balin is incredibly important, because he gives that passive leadership every time he attacks people. To heroes.
Yeah. Sansara's making a move. He's got Forge Blades.
So now Trevor McGregor is saying he wants me to cut your head with a chainsaw.
And he just proved my point, so thank you, Trevor. Alright.
Why would you wish that on somebody, though? That's fucked. Fully upgraded them Lodger's Elves going in with the Lore Master stun. That is totally balanced and fair. Remember when you tried to use Taze the Rainbow and the effect didn't go off? That sucked.
Yeah, that cut me deep. That hurt. I was so excited.
I said at the time, I was like, he's probably so excited. Watch back the stream archive. That's literally what I said.
I kind of want to watch back the stream of my match.
Yeah.
One, I want to hear the rage at the end of that first, like, DC and then.
Well, it wasn't really rage so much as me.
I kind of want to. Yeah, I kind of want to hear your perspective on like how he did as well. So yeah,
did pretty good.
Erdogan is surrounded, and they are getting hacked by about 4 Murkrow Archers.
They're getting hacked or pierced.
Well, pierced, but I'm gonna stick with hacked because fuck that.
So their social media account passwords have been stolen.
Sure.
Was the joke that bad?
Haldir's second chin's level 5. Lore Masters are going off.
I like how he's got less health than the dwarf did at level 1.
I like how they're covering all the basics. They've got one Haldir on range and one Haldir on his sword. I like that. They're leaving no Haldir unturned. That's good.
Even the lore masters can turn the tide.
Although they've got Celeborn now.
Yeah, Celeborn's pretty good.
Don't worry, that hobbit farm will win the day.
They're really chasing him down, though. Look at that. Sam's are actually put defensive measures on a farm. I guarantee you, watch, if they lose this, Devils is going to try to blame it on Sam, so he's going to be all salty about it, even though he lost Thorin Oakenshield.
Let me check the income of all the players. What do we got? We got Heisenberg, he's got a decent amount. Devils, yeah, has got nothing.
Devils has a bunch of double income farms on the outside, but he hasn't got any pantry upgrades yet, except for one on the inside.
Has he rebuilt Thorin yet?
Yeah, yep, he literally just got him.
That's where all his money went. Okay, the Unburnt are coming out? No, those are just regular Guardians.
The problem is he's not getting any Mithril. Like, Thorin Brokenshield does not become Thorin Brokenshield until he has Mithril. That is the thing that breaks him. That and Feely and Keely giving him leadership and Balin giving him leadership. So those three things just make him just unbelievably powerful.
Yeah, and he's fully upgraded his mineshaft, so if he was to destroy one now to get the travel camp, that's just a lot of wasted time and money.
Yeah, he should have gone for the travel camp right off the bat. I mean, it's a 4K start. He could have rushed for it and got the veterans out quickly. Combined with
two mighty elven armies approaching Devils now, though. He's got new problems.
Oh, yeah, they're going to double him to deal with the biggest threat.
With Quick Beam.
Well, what they perceive to be the biggest threat. I personally think that Imladris is better than Erid Luin when you take Lore Masters into account. Oh, that knockback, though. Combo that with Luthien, and you can disable entire armies. Why on earth are you going out to fight that, Devils? You're not going to win.
I remember when he made that second mark, but still. That was so funny. Oh, shit! There's the Dwarven Custom Heroes. That was the, slam. The Custom Hero slam.
Oh, Legolas is on the field. The machine gun of Middle-earth has arrived.
Good job, Quick Bane.
Quick leap.
Celeborn, you're surrounded. They might get Celeborn. This could be a good victory for Devils. And Celeborn's dead. Thorin's level 4. He'll have King onto the mountain. Yep, resources per kill. Oh
Holy
my.
Crap.
If Thorin manages to win, or if Devils manages to push this back, then that will just be amazing.
Thorin is strong, but I don't think he's that strong. That's a lot of elves.
Tower elves, and that's probably just.
And he's running away his slow ass Dwarven hero on aggressive stuff.
Well. Samsara's still not backing him up. If he had come in already, then that would have caused some major problems. There's a lot of ants now. Oh, shit.
Alright, well, all the heroes have escaped.
Haldir's second chin is quite low, but he's still going in. Palace guards are going in. If he loses Thorin, it's all over now. March
of the Ents. I remember one video you made a long time in vanilla, and somebody summoned it randomly, and at the end you were like, I don't know, sure, just gave me an erection. It was pretty spot on.
You should feel proud. Howard Shore is Canadian.
I fucking do feel proud, man.
Yeah. If he was English, he would be knighted by the Queen.
That music track for the Ants is like, it's so good. Yeah, almost as good
every,
as Rohan.
Every track in Lord of the Rings fits perfectly with what it wants to do.
Every track in Lord of the Rings, except for the evil ones. They suck. Because fuck evil.
Imladris is gonna kill a Haldir? Actually, no, they're not. They're upgraded, yet Haldir is somehow tanking it. That Galathrim armor is tanking.
Look at that clump, though. If he brings his custom hero out in the mineshaft and does a leap, think of the carnage.
Yep.
Oh, he's got his heroes killing Quickbeam, trying to kill Quickbeam and failing because the Ents are so fucking overpowered.
Yep. Custom hero does have his leap, he does have invulnerability. He's also got the Forged Dwarven Blades, where you can grant heroes more power. Yep, he's got invulnerable. Ents are wrecking the dwarves, though. Jeez.
Ents wreck everything.
Boom! And I think he missed the bulk of the forces.
That got him level 9!
He's already got improved leap, so no cooldown for him. Oh, Jesus, Sapper. He's right in the middle. Oh my god, that Sapper though, but the Citadel's gone down anyway.
What the fuck? That's supposed to be a structure killer. I had no idea that you can do that.
Jeez. Yeah, it does excellent damage to structures. Apparently, Mirkwood Swordsmen are structures now.
That's pretty fucked.
Dude, that he actually managed to...
That killed, like, his entire army!
How many power points does Devils have now? He's got 8 points now. He can get tier 3. I think he can get... He went with the runes. What connects to the runes? Is it Gandalf, or is it something else?
Well, the runes are tier 2.
Yeah, I know, but then he has enough for tier 3, so...
He got Gandalf.
Alright, cool.
Gandalf is gonna Shrek some elves.
Yep, there he is.
I mean, on the upside, though, Samsara is getting a lot of time to build up. Oh my god! Samsara has the ring, he has the fellowship.
Wait, where?
In the north, northern outpost.
Heisenberg and Snusim, if you fuck this up, Devils, how did you hold? Is it seriously just that Dwarven hero?
I mean, Thorin, the fellowship is here now, you just can't kill them, they don't die.
I mean, you can kill the hobbits.
Even that is tricky. Like, Frodo and Sam have a lot of health.
Yeah, Frodo and Sam, but Merry and Pippin will die quickly.
Yeah.
They actually let some Sauron... How the fuck did he hold? He had enough Ents. That makes no sense.
It was that dwarven fucking Sapper move, man. That was bullshit.
Dude, that was crazy, because they sent an Ents and everything.
I got a perfect cam of that. It killed, like, half of his army. It was stupid.
That was crazy. Well done, Devils, for holding out.
Well, we got Silverborn on the field now.
Yeah, he's got... So, yeah, Lauren's got their upgrades as well as Imladris.
Silverborn, they do a bit of damage. They're pretty good.
A bit of damage. Pretty good. There's a reason why they cost 700.
I think they're the most expensive upgrade in the game, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. Nothing top 700.
Like on a per unit basis.
In 1.9, I think they're 300.
Well,
maybe 400.
Well, they also nerfed the shit out of them. Apparently, in 1.8, the elves actually do double damage every time they gain a level.
Oh,
so at level 10,
okay.
Mirkwood's just like fucking just ridiculously powerful.
Yeah, because Harmon was complaining that the Mirkwoods were a bit underwhelming. So you just have to level them up then, and they're good?
No, they used to. They got rid of it. They do standard scaling damage as they level up now, so the Mirkwoods aren't overpowered as shit anymore. Also, they gave them the extra units in the battalions, so they're a bit weaker now.
Heisenberg has made the Lady of Light.
Oh my god.
How is the model in this?
The Fellowship, though. I mean, there's just no stopping the Fellowship.
How
they're
the
so
fuck
good.
Did he find the Fellowship? I didn't even realize Gollum was on the field.
Yeah, I caught it just as Elrond was picking up the ring. I was looking around, seeing what he was doing, and I saw it. So
well, think of it this way: it could be worse. It could be Dagor. So Elrond could be Ring Hero right about now.
I think the Fellowship is better than Dagor Ring Elrond. To be honest with you,
no. Oh. The flood's an army kill.
Oh. We're about to get some return Sapper here, maybe. Oh no,
wow,
the hairy armpit!
That... You killed the armpit!
You merciless bastards!
You monster. How could you kill your own kind, Devils? How could you do that? Dude, the comeback is real. We've got some high quality games in this tournament.
Yeah.
I mean, damn.
I thought they had that in the bag, to be honest.
I mean,
he's
gone full cake, not all. He's doing well.
Those lore master stuns, though.
I love watching the Fellowship fight. Look at that. Aragorn in his Strider outfit, Boromir.
He's ripping everything to shreds.
They're focusing their Silverthorns on the Fellowship, that's wise. Gotta get rid of them quickly.
That leap, though.
When the custom hero does a leap, he actually does a 360.
Yeah, all of the leaping heroes do 360s except for Gimli.
Oh, okay. Dude, that's cool. Wait, did Galadriel die? She's gone. I think Aragorn just cut down Galadriel.
Holy shit.
Okay, that's a big loss for Heisenberg.
Yeah, that's
All we need now is Dwarven Siege to just take... Oh shit, there's a big battle going on over here. Never mind, Mirkwood's fought back with a vengeance.
Lore Masters are still alive, though. Fellowship is still alive. Lorien definitely is, or the Lorien players, I should say, are definitely not going down without a fight. The casual fucks will fight to the last man. We have the casual fucks versus the dedicated scumbags.
So Samsara with his light and earth lore masters can actually imprison units. So you could use that to just single out an enemy hero.
Yeah.
Oh no, is it a friendly hero? No, enemy or friendly, okay.
Yep. Get rid of Thorin Broken Shield from any engagement. Oh, I heard a Nandalad. Haldir died.
Celeborn's died. Well, Celeborn's dead, I should say. There are some massive losses. Thorin Broken Shield is level 7! 3 more levels, he'll be King of the Dwarves. King under the mountain.
Oh, Elrond just died.
Watch out, Thorin, the palace guards are not going for you. They're gonna let you live, actually.
How did you lose Elrond? My goodness. I don't know why he's running away, the Fellowship. The Fellowship, just you can just throw them in there, it doesn't even matter.
Let's get in there. Devils, if I look at your base and you're not making siege, god damn it. Get rid of that hearth, get some catapults, there's so many hills on this damn map, you could take down Mirkwood in 2 hits.
No, he's probably going to get an outpost to get it there.
Alright, has he built one?
That's I mean, the Lorien Eco is still unbelievable.
Yeah.
I mean, fucking... Heisenberg has a float of 6,000 right now. Devils has 3,000. Samsara's got 5.
That's Heisenberg.
Snoozon's the only one who's actually spending his money.
Gandalf, that was a waste. Unless you're going to commit to a full attack, Devils, I don't know why you use that. Unless you're going to try and take out the Ents.
I mean, yeah, like... But that's the thing about Gandalf summon, is you can't really run away from it. Like, the tracking on the dragon is so good.
It just seemed like a waste, though, because he's not actually attacking. He just wasted a good tier 3 power.
He was probably hoping to set the Ents on fire, but it takes more than that. Hmm. He's getting wrecked by Haldir's hairy armpit.
And he's gonna level up. There we go, Lada.
Might see a bit of return sapper damage.
Yeah, I was just about to say, he's got sapper as well. So what goes around comes around, folks.
Bombard and leap.
The armpit sapper is real.
He's gone for straight crowd control. He's almost got 8,000 health on level 3. That's fucking crazy.
But I think there should be an amendment to a Dane where at tier 4 you get summon Goodfella and you just summon him to the game. He just wins it for you.
That wouldn't even be fair. That's like a tier 8.
Yeah, Earthquake or summon Goodfella.
Choice is obvious.
Dude, I think we did well choosing this map. Like, there's been a lot of good battles in here.
Yeah.
Fellowship at level 4, they've got for Frodo. And obviously.
Oh no, how do his hairy armpit? He's gonna go down to the Fellowship. Oh, Haldir's second chin, though. He's standing against the Fellowship.
Yeah, somehow. He's got Blade Master. Gandalf has fallen. The Fellowship might die. Oh, God.
Oh, that spear throw just destroyed Legolas.
There is only 3 members left of the Fellowship. Only 2 members left of the... Oh, no, there's like 5. Sorry. There's like 5. Yeah, yeah. That was close.
That's what I mean. Like, his hero just destroyed Aragorn and Legolas, but as long as one little guy survives...
Yep. And Boromir's pretty tanky.
I mean, thank Gandalf God. Is still there. Look at that regen.
Wait, Gandalf is there? He's already regened Aragorn. What the fuck? What? He literally died 5 seconds ago.
Nah, he was just taking a short rest.
Jeez.
This might be the best match of the tourney.
No. Mine's better, clearly.
Well, I mean, with yours, you just kind of destroyed them, but this one's actually back and forth.
Yeah, this is actually very even. I thought it was game over, but no, they fought back. Really?
Oh, yeah. I thought it was over, too, but then that fucking clutch sapper came in.
Clutch sapper. That's what I want to call this.
He killed, like, 6 battalions of units. It was ridiculous.
Yep. But as we said, they've got sapper.
I didn't even know that did damage to units. I thought it was the structure killer, like in Vanilla.
Yeah. Seriously, Devils, if you make one catapult, I mean, I know early win catapults aren't that good, but that
will I do a bathroom events. Break? Yes, after the fourth game, I'm going to take a quick 10-minute break to let everybody go and stretch their legs. Problem is, we had such a delay, I want to actually get the fucking, at least to the semifinals here.
Alright, looks like they're attacking Samsara's base. They made the mistake of letting him upgrade.
Hey,
all of Samsara's army is actually at Devil's base. They're obviously not expecting an attack, so they could actually deal with this. They have the advantage. Seriously, there's nothing defending Samsara's base.
Oh, Samsara.
Now they're hightailing it. Now they're hightailing it.
Samsara doesn't have it. He does have the one outpost. He does have the Duranon camp, so that'll keep him alive at least.
Is he going for the Citadel or is he going for the towers?
Citadel.
That's Citadel. They have to destroy this now, otherwise their armies will be trapped. But that's a lot of fucking
What they should be doing is they should be going after the enemy bases, since they've just committed all their armies. Like, if they're not going to be able to reach that and save the base in time, they'd do better to go for
that,
the enemy
that
bases.
That still wouldn't work, though, because they can take out the bases, but the bottom team has, like, 3 outposts, so they still wouldn't be out, whereas the top team will be out.
Oh, Devil's hero is here.
The dwarves arrived. Oh, he used Undermine. He's going to just try and get in there and sap him.
He's got a 30-second invulnerability. That's so unfair.
Sapper, he's done it. Let's get in there. Wait, did it go off?
He should go in there first. Yeah, that's what he's going to do. He's going to go in and use... Oh my god, so many kills about to happen here.
Rip.
Oh my god.
They just killed over dead, and that's a building damn. That's a building killer, apparently.
It took Treebeard down to red health.
Jesus. Wow.
And then he can go in and leap on the rest of them.
Yeah, rip Samsara. You guys did so well.
Samsara is still good to go. He's got a lot of money.
Yeah, but his base is gone.
Oh, never mind. He didn't have a lot of money. He must have spent it. But they're going to pay for that with their entire army. And I'm not even
base?
Sure
I think
get
that's
the base.
Pretty good.
Yeah, the elves don't have quite as much money as I was expecting.
Oh, putting all your eggs in one basket. Jeez. I wonder if they knew that he was there. They just had a hunch that they were both defending one base. Or was it just luck? I don't know.
I don't know why he's keeping his army outside. He needs to get in there and kill those elves before they kill his fortress.
Thorin's arrived, level 7. Actually, all those Ents died from the Sapper. The Citadel might be able to rebuild itself. Because the Linden Archers are here.
Yeah.
I swear to God, if this attack actually fails...
Oh, it failed. It's already over. It's failed.
Shit! Okay, I agree. This has been the best game of the tournament.
That Sapper killed the entire Archer division that they had. Every single
match.
And then the Leap killed a good portion of the Galathrim melee warriors. That Dwarven hero, the name is not misleading. He is going to kill you.
Devil's Daemon has a lot of power points. He's got 2 tier 3 of powers. He could go for Earthquake and just completely Shrek him.
Earthquake isn't really very good versus Lorien bases.
No, but you could completely disintegrate Mirkwood, but...
Can it kill a Mirkwood? I don't think it can. I think it does about half health to it.
It would destroy the attachments, huh?
No, I think it does about half health to them, too.
Wow. Well,
Earthquake is pretty bad, honestly. It's pretty bad.
He's got his ponies out, finally. He's going to get his Mithril soon. And the base is just fully rebuilding. Oh my god, Samsara. You cheeky.
But now they're making the same mistake, except in reverse. They're leaving Devil's Base completely unguarded.
Yeah, but there's no Elven... Oh, there are. They're just... not complete.
Hey, he finally got some ponies.
Ponies. I love ponies. But yeah, he's getting...
My little pony. I'm sorry.
My little pony.
I'm so sorry. I take it back.
I don't. Alright. They're attacking one of the Mirkwoods.
Yeah, I mean, once the leveled up Thorin hits the field, at that point, if you don't have Imladris to stop him, there's just no killing him.
They got a leveled up Elrond, leveled up Thorin, leveled up Fellowship.
There are two definitive counters to Thorin Broken Shield, and those are Shieldbearer Spam and Imladris Lore Masters. That's it. There's no other counters.
Rip.
Although, interestingly, I think that Gimli and the Thorin Stonehelms actually beat Broken Shield in 1v1s.
Yeah, I'd imagine Stonehelm would do it if you combo his two abilities, last two abilities. And yeah.
Well, the big thing is the invulnerability, so you got to be careful not to waste your abilities. You sort of got to run around and lead him on until his invulnerability runs out. Because it only lasts for 15 seconds, I think, so...
Alright, fully upgraded Mirkwoods mobilizing. That's a lot. That's just an entire army of Galadhrim. Some Karas Galathon.
That's your best bet. How do your second chin is there?
Mineshaft. No siege works yet. Alright.
Don't underestimate Blademaster Spear Throw from How do your second chin. Especially if you went for mainly damage. That could probably even do a lot of damage even to Thorin.
Yep. Cousin Vets have entered the forge. They are now wailing away. I love that animation that they
have. It is time for Thorin to become Thorin Broken Shield.
And he's got Balin as well.
And he's also probably given him the forged weapon, so 10% more damage from his custom hero.
Yep. Clever strategy, actually. The Ents are destroying the citadel from the hill. Oh, well done, Heisenberg. If the dwarves decide to charge, then Galadhrim will just completely mow them down. Well, fuck, that's a citadel wasted. Rip.
Bloody Ents.
The Lorien players have used their Ents really well.
Yeah, Ents are just overpowered in general.
I'm just thinking with them lodges, I mean, they don't get fire arrows, so...
Golden arrows do quite a bit of damage, though.
LOL. Rip Galadhrim.
What happened?
Gandalf just dragoned them.
Oh,
they're still alive though, and Gandalf is pretty much dead, so he should probably go back and heal his Galadhrim.
It's an odd time to use that. All right, whereabouts is Thorin? I want to see his damage with that buff.
They're launching a massive attack on Imladris again. Oh, and the dwarves are there. So,
is Thorin dead?
No, he's definitely in there.
Oh, he just got Balin back.
Look for the guy with an oaken shield.
Look for the guy with an oaken shield.
There he is, Thorin. He's fighting Haldir in the middle, next to one of the Ents. Thorin is level 7 still. He hasn't equipped the Mithril. Purchase the Mithril, devils! Thorin's about to die. He'll probably get him out. What are you doing, devils? Thorin is one kick away from an Ent to death. Ooh, now he uses it. Treebeard almost killed Thorin, confirmed.
Yeah, Treebeard is fucking unbelievably powerful.
Does Devils not know you have to purchase the Mithril on the heroes individually?
I have no idea.
Or does it not show up for observers?
Last March of the Ents. Man, those Lorien armies, they're tanky. This is what this is the problem is, Devils didn't level up all of his heroes, he only leveled up Thorin. You need more than just Thorin.
There's some level 5 unburnt about to track an Ent, I kinda need to see how this goes.
Well, Feely or Killy died, or yours. What?! Oh, down goes, you will die, he's dead.
Yep, he's gone. In about 3 seconds.
Yep.
Plop. That's the sound effect.
So, Thorin has 695 damage. I think that's vanilla. I don't think he's buffed him. Wonder what happened if you use the Force weapons on the Fellowship.
They're rallying for one. Oh, yeah. I wonder if you can. That'd be considerably OP. Just 10% buff to each hero. As long as Samsara has... Oh, as long as he's Imladris, he's not going to fall.
They're he's got the Fellowship. It's just such a hard-hitting force to deal with.
And he's got Athelos on him, because they're level 5.
Oh, the boat. The balance boat. Although he has archers.
Look at the range on those archers, though. That is crazy range. Do Linden archers give bonus range or something? Or have they always been that good? That's crazy.
They've got a formation that gives them damage. And then they have a leadership that gives shooting speed and armor against arrows.
Alright.
The main range comes from the Imladris archers who can use their formation. And they get a bunch of range from it.
Alright.
What's it called? Square formation, they get 30% range. Or no, they lose range. That's right.
Oh, it just seemed really large then. Never mind. They've got like 4 ants.
I don't think they're holding this. Just because of the boat being there, it's so not fair.
I mean, they came back from his whole base being destroyed once already, so...
We go.
Yeah, but Devil's custom hero was there for that, and his custom hero is dead right now.
Shipped.
Oh, he's back. I think he's gonna get there.
Custom hero's going in. He's gonna leap. He's gonna leap. I would imagine he's gonna leap. Nope, he's doing Sapa. And, yep. Ooh. Elder's very armpit is about to die. Do a leap before he dies. Quickly, leap on him.
I don't think they got the micro skill.
Yeah, he's dead. And now we've got the level up. So did the Fellowship, by the way.
Oh my god, another boat.
They synced up the boats, yep.
Yeah, okay. Devils needs to go for one of their bases right now. He cannot stop this attack. He needs to go for a base. He's not going to, but that's what he needs to do. Although they did kill all the seas, so that'll slow them down quite substantially.
Well, they got Treebeard left. There goes the Citadel. Treebeard, you tanky mother Fuhrer. He's being hit by like 18 heroes and he's still standing.
It's mainly the archers. Although, archers just ripped through it. What a game.
Yeah, I know, right? Jeez.
You don't use
I thought this was filthy casual cup. What the hell?
I know.
Can these guys fight in my tournament? Gee.
I can't believe they held that. I cannot believe they held that under the boat. He didn't have the boat over any of the seas. That's why he could have had the boat over Treebeard, and he didn't.
Rip Galathrim. Careful.
Oh, Devils used Earthquake somewhere. He used it on the bottom left base. You can see it did, like, no damage.
Oh, yeah. Well, Heisenberg's retreating with what's left of his Grand Army.
It's Heisenfuck.
Sorry, Snooze Derp and Heisenfuck. Fellowship's level 5? You thought they'd be higher level. There's been a lot of action.
I love the animations for the fucking dwarf costume hero waddling along.
Yeah, it's the famous
they're
Dane
Waddle.
They're
so fat.
Yeah. I believe the correct term is rotund.
Oh, hey, I just realized Balin uses that when he walks. Never seen him side by side before. Holy crap, look at the back of Devil's Daemon. It looks like another face.
Devil's Daemon's face?
The back of Devil's Daemon's custom hero. Hold the back on. Of his head.
Where is he?
He went into a mine shaft, but when he takes him out, look at the back of his head. It looks like a face. Seriously, it looks like
second face is real.
It looks like a weird cartoon Italian face. Where did he take him out? He took him out back by his base. Look at the back of his head. He's right in the middle. Stop moving, devils.
Hold on, I say
it's gotta be standing still for you to really see it.
I can't believe this is what I'm focused on during the downtime. We just had like the most epic battle of all time, and then this is...
Well, there's nothing going on now.
Stop moving your custom hero, you prick.
Alright, there you go. Look.
Oh, that is too perfect. It's like a really bad Santa cosplay.
How did I notice that is what
that
I really want to
so
know.
So good. Look at that face.
It looks like he's got like a... It looks like a kawaii dwarf. He's like smiling.
Yeah, we found the first weeb dwarf in all of Mario. Fucking great. Well done, Cryptic. You struck gold.
And then you compare that to his portrait. He's like, yeah. I am not happy about this.
The elves are mobilizing for another attack. I honestly think it would be better to attack the dwarves because at Samsara's base there are undermines everywhere so they could easily get to him.
Yeah.
But in saying that, Samsara's going on the offensive. He's had enough of this shit. He's channeling his inner league player.
To his credit, I don't think Samsara has lost Howdier yet. Oh, wait, no, he didn't have Howdier. What am I talking about?
Technically he hasn't lost him, then. He never made it.
Also, to his credit, he has not lost the Fellowship.
Samsara is about to engage two whole elven armies with custom heroes. Devils is scratching his bum or something. He's used the moat thing or whatever it's called to freeze the entire army.
Yeah.
If I was Heisenberg and all that, I would tell them to focus the Fellowship immediately. Boromir's almost dead. Gandalf's about to fall.
Yep, he's level 5, but he has more abilities than that. Oh!
Clutch play, devils! That is such a damaging move.
It's pretty hard to counter that.
Boom! There it goes.
And then the fireworks on the remaining clump. He's just an army killer. He can just nuke everything.
Yep.
Pine cones!
He's gone. All those archers in the back, and Tears of the Valor. Rip.
This has been just the best game.
Yep. Tears of the Valor is really hard to land, but when it does...
There's people in the chat who are pissed off and say that I didn't say, like, kawaii writer or something. I don't know. Listen, I'm not a weeboo, okay? Like, I don't understand the whole culture. It's foreign to me.
It's almost like it's a foreign culture. Alright, I don't want to start any waifu wars, so let's not get into it.
Well, you are kind of a weeb, so at least you know what you're talking about.
Well,
not as much as Mac.
Oh no, he's gone full weeb. The dwarves are 100%
weeb.
Although they use that spell to buff their
JB1776, freaking weeboos.
And there's another. Is it Tears of the Valor or Reign of the Valor? I think Tears of the Valor is dagger.
I think it's Tears. I mean, you can just pop over to them and look at it. It's Reign of the Valor.
Reign of the Valor. I thought it was. Right.
Should be Tears.
Devils has Earthquake and Citadel.
Oh, he's also got a dwarf.
If he's really clever, he could summon a Citadel.
Oh my god, Thorin Broken Shield is fighting Howdier's hairy armpit. Oh, Broken Shield won.
That's a way to get level 10. And the Sapper went off, jeez. There's too much to keep up with. So you can get Glimmer the Arkenstone.
Chopped to bits.
Oh my god. The custom heroes just makes this a fucking mess. It's amazing.
It's even better knowing that he's got a weeboo face on the back of his head.
I know. That's the source of his true power.
Or whatever. These battles have been... face or whatever.
Chan Chan Neku Neku.
Oh, Balin killed an ant. Balin is Balin after all.
Celeborn is dead. You will die, just killed Celeborn. How appropriate. Delos has done well, I have to say.
Yeah.
But I think his custom hero will die. Delos'
custom hero has done well. Yes. Look at those ants. My god, the ant spam. That's the one thing that Lorien can do at this point.
Okay. It seems Mirkwood. Wait, is Helder? I thought Helder was floating.
Something
for a second.
Just destroyed Balin. He got
Thorin
fucking...
is still alive after all that. People, if you wonder why we call him Broken Shield, it's because he's still going long after his army is dead.
Oh yeah.
And now he's just
he's
like
usually the last person standing.
Yep. And I
he
think
he can still save him. He just didn't want to, but he could have easily still saved him. But I mean, he's got 8k in the bank, so he can just revive all these
yeah.
ships.
Seriously, if he summoned a Dwarven Citadel in the bottom right, he could easily destroy the Elven base. Like, if they're distracted in the heat of battle, then that could be a good idea.
And props to the casual fucks for surviving.
They are indeed casual fucks. In fact, they're not. They've done way better than I thought.
They're not just surviving, they're thriving. Look at that army.
Samsara's army's on the move. Does Samsara not know you can... Wait, can you not rebuild camp walls?
Oh... Samsara's got the last alliance on stand. Would have actually been better to go for the Flood.
You say the Flood, I just think of Halo.
I need a weapon.
Come on, Casual Fox, commit, you can do it.
They've got like 10 ends.
And a level 5, well, that's not even cheaper, that's just a level 5 end. Well, no matter the outcome, both teams can hold their heads high, because they've done superb, really.
Mogat says he can come back if he starts building towers immediately. I don't think he can. I think that that's 10 ents.
Dude, Mogat?
Well, not 10, but it's like... Oh yeah, Mogat's been watching.
Dude, nice.
Elendil's cousin from the forums has also been watching.
Citadel's here.
That's not going to last too long against all those...
You should have summoned it in the olden days. That's what I would have done. Last troll move. Did the Lost Alliance get summoned, or am I just crazy? Oh, right under my nose.
Yep. Those hero powers can actually do a bit of damage. Gil-galad is poking an ent and doing no damage.
Well, they didn't destroy the doors quick enough because Imladris' army is here with the Fellowship.
Oh, yeah, the back. Those golden arrows are going to rip through those ends so quickly.
Fucking hell. I feel so sorry for these Lorien armies because they're trying their hardest to win and they're just getting sandwiched every time. How often do you see that, though? Like, an entire base be destroyed and yet the player still survives. Like, that was...
Jesus Christ, that fucking Dwarven custom hero. He just keeps nuking armies. Who needs Earthquake when you've got that sapper in the leap?
Is it too late to change my custom hero now?
Nope. You can change it up whatever you want. I don't give a fuck.
Oh, shit. Well, he's got a couple ents. Oh, no, about one ent left now.
Logan says, towers counter everything. If not, I will quit.
He's not wrong. Actually, no, he seriously isn't wrong. If you go for battle tower training, then yeah. You cut through that elven armor in seconds. There's the flood.
Oh, the flood. Well, that... was a disgusting slaughter of
Samsara with the clutch play. That's that sandwich though.
They could take this aggression and push now and they could get some map control.
Yeah. Maybe the
although oh my god, look
maybe
at
the
army spam
will finally
already
go down.
Look at the amount of troops they've already that friggin' Susan's already got on the field. He's got like 5 battalions already. He's just got them queued up. Hey, Horn of Gondor.
One of what Gondor? What is this Gondor? I don't know what a Gondor is.
Max, you can see who's fighting by looking at the bottom left of the screen. I've got the team names up.
Fellowship levels up very slowly.
Well, it doesn't level. It's bugged. It just over time it eventually hits level 10.
Okay.
It's still got that same bug that it had back in the betas a long time ago because they didn't fix it.
I honestly thought they fixed it. What the hell?
Nope.
Okay. This is turning.
And Warcry is the best one.
This is turning into a stalemate. I'm largest on the counter. All the big powers have been used up now. All the big powers, like Flood, Lost Lions, they've all been used up. Citadel.
Yep. Look at him, Lodris, just cut through that Lorien army. That's Roscobel the power rabbits, of Lodris-like game.
Roscobel rabbits are trying to irritate Gildor. Gildor is losing.
These are Roscobel rabbits.
Elrond's level 7, he's got Restoration, so he can just refresh his custom hero's abilities. You know,
why on earth would you ever use the rabbits? Like, his foot form is just so much better. Seriously.
Oh no, I like the rabbits, actually. I think they're pretty good.
I like them too, but it doesn't change the fact that they suck.
No, he can call in an eagle, he can heal, and then he debuffs everything. I like that.
Yeah, but so can the eagle form, and the foot form has a wizard blast and a really powerful AoE too. Oh, how dare second gen died.
There goes the loot.
Oh, he's got bombard on. He's good to go.
I never use custom hero bombard, and that's why.
He didn't actually use it yet.
Oh, okay. One came down.
Yeah, that's like a marker, but then he ordered them to move. That comes down to like mark the area type thing, give the enemy a warning.
All right.
And then the actual bombard comes in.
Dude, that Ent is still. Yeah, now the Ent's dead. Wait, did he do what I told him to do? Oh, snap. Bottom right. He used Undermine. How the hell did an army of Unburnt take down an entire Lorien base?
That was underhanded, but then again, they did do that 2v1 rush against Samsara twice. So, it's just a taste of their
own
medicine.
That's not underhanded. That's... Did he must have...
Yeah, he used Underhand. He sneaked an army in while they were away fighting Samsara.
But did he use Earthquake as well? Because there's no way he would have been able to destroy a Lorien base that quickly. Dude, that was crazy. Well,
Earthquake is freshly off cooldown, so yeah, he must have.
That was some great play. Well done.
I was busy watching the epic battle in the middle.
Yeah, I know.
Well, it wasn't really an epic battle so much as Imladris just cleaning house.
Dude, Lore Masters combined with all those archers.
There's just no killing them.
Although the boat's
The balance
out.
Boat is there now, though.
Elrond's about to die, watch out!
You know what's real great about the boat? It makes you unable to see or use your units. See how they're just standing there?
Elrond just ran away from Haldir. What? And a Mirkwood's going to fall soon. Unlucky Snussum, whatever the hell your name is.
Well, he's still got another Mirkwood in the south, so even with that one dead, he's not dead.
Look at Balin go.
The eagles are coming!
Actually, I just realized how he would have taken out the base. Oh no, he didn't use Sapper, unless it's off cooldown. Unless it cools down quickly. But yeah, the custom hero could probably level a base.
Well, he did definitely use Earthquake. Mm. Just judging by its cooldown when I looked at it. So it's possible he used
Damn.
Both.
How the fuck do you beat this combo? You could just wait until Mighty Sapper and then Earthquake and just nuke a base.
The thing I love about this is impromptu. They didn't have any chance to plan out a strategy like Stu Som and Heisenfuck did.
Middle Mirkwood's down, being replaced with Imladris barracks.
Although I'd be lying if I didn't say that I was sad to see the death of Haldir's hairy armpit and his second gen. I wanted to see them progress so badly.
and Lardris are going to seal the deal now. Is that his only Entmoot?
I think
that's his only Entmoot, yep.
Oh, but he can get the Treebeard Ent Summon Stomp out. That would nuke so much of his army.
Yep, there it is. Right on cue, Crypto.
Use the stomp! Use the stomp, you fool! Use the stomp!
I think he knows. Oh, I think he knows. Oh, he didn't do it.
See how much damage the Ents do, though, to Imladris? Yeah. The Ents can really...
And,
if you can avoid them getting shot.
And Treebeard gets the Elder Boons from the Elder F thing.
Yep. Yeah, just Siege in general is Imladris' worst nightmare. That and Archers are the two best counters to Imladris.
Ganondorf didn't get to do his dragon thing off. He keeps getting knocked over by the Ents. Oh, there he goes.
Well, oh, he hit them after they were knocked down. That was weird. If he would have stopped those archers, it would have been so many fucking kills.
We should make a tournament where everyone's Lauren, and if you lose Haldir, you lose the match.
Haldir survival.
Yeah, exactly. Everyone just like keeps him firmly protected in the base. Like, don't leave.
Last Haldir standing.
Oh, that'd be so good.
Could be the name of the tournament. I don't know if that's a tournament, but that could certainly be an 8-player video with some subscribers.
Yes, hunt the Haldir. That'd be awesome. He's rebuilt the Lorien base, but I don't think it's going to last much longer.
Oh, he did spam out them Mirkwoods, though.
There it goes.
Ah, so, the boat.
Viewers, ratings out of 10 for this match. If it's not 10 out of 10, I don't know what you want. This has been the highest caliber match. This has been great.
Yeah. I definitely give this one at least a 9. There's been a lot of epic comebacks as well from both sides. Like the one taking place in Snoozom's base.
Heisenberg
right now
doesn't give up, does he? He repelled Imladris, yep. He's rebuilt his Entmoot. Holy shit.
Mortimer the Inquisitor says 12 out of 10. 20 yep. out of 10. Potato yep. out of 10.
Potato out of 10. Shit, it's not that good. Fuck. Shit, are you sure about that? 10. Are you sure?
Oh my god, that was a dwarven slaughter right there. So many dead beards. Roz, avert your eyes. Oink, oink, little piggies!
Oink, oink, little piggies! We love Boindle. All that's left is the Lone Tower.
Friggin' Samsur has still got that unchallenged Imladris Supremacy army, though.
I'm watching this Lone Tower die. There we go.
Mirkwood saved Lorien.
What is that? Is that Auron level 10? When the fuck did you get Auron level 10? He's running him in! One man Elrond!
Yeah!
Look at that! Rip Galathrim. Lol.
Look at how nerfed down it is compared to when it... You remember the beta?
Yeah.
You remember you bitching about us, bitching about it being overpowered in the beta?
Yeah. And now look what's happened. It does fuck all. That's what I was worried about.
I didn't think it needed to be nerfed down that much, but it was bad. Mm-hmm. You combine that with Glorfindel's level 10 in the beta, you could kill any army in the game. It was so broken. Good times. I don't know if I told you about the game me and Haman had, but I think he killed something like 20,000 of my Rohirrim with those two heroes alone. And he couldn't kill me because Imladris Siege is so bad. So eventually I just won because of Glorious Charge. But yeah, I lost like 20,000 units and it was pretty much just him using Glorfindel and Elrond and Elrond.
The Entmoot's going down for the second time.
Are you going to upload this whole game or are you going to have to cut it?
Whole thing's going up.
It's going to be like a 2-hour game.
This hasn't actually gotten stale, though. That's why it's surprising. Like, it's been enthralling. Yeah.
pretty much constant action back and forth all over the place. Oh, I think it's time for Snoop Song to say goodbye to his base. That's a lot of angry Arcan Guard, or Unburnt, rather. Look at all those beards. Oh, you pissed off the dwarves now, laddie. Oh, making them invulnerable. Just cutting through everything. Oh, he could use the charge right now and get so many fucking kills. He's not doing it.
Yeah, I was waiting for that, actually. I was like, he knows. It's not coming out.
Oh, he used it on one of them. Oh, two of them. Minstrel singing. That's copyrighted, Russ.
No, that's just singing over it, Cryptic. That's how you avoid copyright. You just sing over it.
You have to be louder than the game, too.
How many times the devils want to destroy this? Make a demolisher crew ladder. I'll get the job done. An Ent can't kick a demolisher.
Yeah, I can. I think we're finally approaching the end now, though.
The Citadel's come up at Heisenberg's base. But he needs to take down that Ent, otherwise that Citadel's in trouble. Snoozoom can siege, GG. This match, well done. As I said, hold your head up high, you did excellent. Rip Haldir's hairy arm. But his custom hero names was just a premonition that this was going to be an epic game.
Oh, man.
I'm going to talk with my grandchildren about this match. Alright, we're in the final stretch now. Citadel's hitting the base. If they just unite for one big push.
Haldir's second chin and Haldir still stand. All is not lost.
I love Haldir fighting alongside his second chin. If only Craig Parker knew.
I'll bet you he does. They have like publicists who watch shit like that.
Yeah.
I bet you somebody has slipped through to him somehow.
Yeah. Like, your chin is famous.
He knows that, you know, he was a fat elf because he said it in that one interview.
Yeah. I love that, how he conceded, yeah, it's a fat elf.
Oh, man.
Does Devils have Earthquake? Oh, Earthquake is almost back. That's what they're going to be waiting for. He's got Gandalf back. Samsara has Bombadil. Yeah, so they've got Last Alliance and Earthquake back. Oh boy.
What a game. And props to Samsara for fucking picking up the slack, man. He jumped into this thing impromptu and he kicked ass.
Yeah, they let him build up and it actually paid off. That should never have worked. That fucking Sapper clutch is what saved it, because that should have been an early win.
Yeah, like, that was it. If it wasn't for that Sapper, it would have been over.
Oh, it's funny how these things go. The one
Sapper... That's gotta be the name of your video.
Sapper Clutch, yeah. Or Clutch
Sapper. Sapper Clutch 2017. Fucking incredible.
Wait, where the hell is the second chin going? The second chin's going on a freaking...
He's going on
He's
the
going in
pressure.
The house. What the fuck? Nope. The elves are just running. I don't know where he's going. Heisenberg's making one last push, like the fucking last Spartans.
The last chins march.
If that's an Ent move, I'm gonna... God damn it.
Yeah, it is. How much money has he got?
He's gonna make Mirkwood. That's an empty outpost over there.
He's got 3,000.
Get ready for the earthquake.
Oh, here comes the army. That base is going to die so quickly. I'm totally not telling Heisenfuck where there are.
There's the earthquake. Get ready for Mighty Sapper in the bottom left. It's coming. Mighty Sapper is going in. In fact, let's zoom in on the clap clap.
Clap, clap, bitches.
Boom. Click, click, boom. Good game, everyone. Well played.
He lives on yet? What the fuck? He made a Lorian outpost. Why would you ever make a Lorian outpost?
Well, he did lose his main base, so...
Well, yeah, but he could have made a Mirkwood. It's just better.
It's literally the last stand of Haldir and his chin. That you couldn't write this any better. It's so good. Like Lorien's long burned down, and it's just this.
He can actually stand and fight, and use the boat, and like fight.
Yeah, it's like we can't kill this fucking chin.
Damn this boat!
Yeah,
and this chin.
Damn that thing's big. All right,
he's Holy actually. Crap. Look at those archers rip through that tower. There's Galathons.
Oh,
they just nuked the poor hobbit on the right, a hobbit lady. The crimes of war. Oh, he's going balls out on the powers, baby.
Full balls deep. That Citadel's taking some wicked damage.
Yerp. Hey, it's Radagast.
Do not speak to me, you're Radagast the Brown.
It's his excessive consumption of mushrooms. They have addled his brains and yellowed his teeth.
Yellowed his teeth. I love that. The second chin is going to die to an arrow tower.
No, he's gonna die to being defeated.
GG. Well played, everyone.
That was incredible. That was such a good game.
It really was.
Oh, man.
Ugh.
Whew. Holy crap. Look at the unit spike for Samsara at the end.
All the summons in one place. Just whoop.
It's like whoop.
And then they live for a little bit, and then the timers run out, and then back down. Well, razzle dazzle, that's the end of the video. Thank you so very much for watching. I just wanted to do a quick shout out to all of our lovely patrons for their support, and of course to our lovely captains of Jondor as well. You guys freaking rock. So if you want to support the channel, go and check out all those links in the description. I Twitch, I Twitter, I do other things. So please check them out if you want. It's cool. You won't regret it. Probably will. I don't know.